Alright, so before lunch, we were doing these guys, and most of you had them pretty well figured out. So how do we start? Here's our problem. This is problem F. How do we start it?
Is that a squiggly line?
I'll put a squiggly line at zero, so right here. This is my squiggly line. And the squiggly line is where the dots are gonna go. These piecewise functions have dots that start the pieces. This is where they go. Alright, let's look at the top equation. What is this? Y equals 2x plus 0. What is that?
Slope of 2.
That's the equation of a line that has a y-intercept of 0 and a slope of 2. So I'm going to go ahead, go 0, up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1. All right, so I'm going to try again to draw this line in here. So there's my red line. All right, what's the next step? Once you get your
find a big point where it crosses.
Wherever it crosses, you're going to put a big dot. Then you pay attention. Do I color in that dot or leave it open?
Leave
it open. So a nice big open dot right there. Okay. And then I'm going to erase half of it. This tells me what to keep. So I'm going to keep that side. And I'm going to erase this side of my line. Now, you still with me? So then I move on to part two. What's that? What's that?
The line.
That's the identity. And what am I down to it?
Down to.
So here's my identity line, down 2. Should have gone through here, but I dropped it down 2. It goes through here. And there's my dot. Every time you draw a shape, it's going to cross your squiggly line. You put a dot where it crosses. This dot is going to be filled in. And I am going to keep the left, so erase the right. I don't really need my squiggly line in there anymore, but there it is. So I've got this little thing, red thing going up this way and a purple thing coming down that way. Will your two pieces ever both be on the same side? Like this is on the right side of the squiggle and this is on the left side of the squiggle. Will they ever be on the same side? No. Because if they were, imagine that, you wouldn't pass the vertical line test. These are all functions. So one side will be right and one side will be left. Alrighty? This is a three-parter. Oh, goodness. All right, so what does that mean to me? How do I start?
A line at negative 2.
I'm going to put a squiggly line at negative 2. And a squiggly line at 1. Purpose of the squiggly lines, they are not really part of the graph, but the purpose of the squiggly lines is to know where the dots go. Alright, tell me about 3x.
Why?
Well, y equals 3x plus 0 is a line.
With
With a slope of 3.
That goes through the origin with a slope of 3/1. So here's the origin. 1, 2, 3/1, 1, 2, 3/1. There it is. Now, which squiggle do I care about with this orange line?
-2.
Just the -2. Do you see that? So I'm going to put a dot right here. I'm going to color that dot in. And then which side am I keeping?
Left.
Left. So I'm erasing right. So all I got out of that first piece is this little guy right down here. What's this? The identity plus 1? X is the identity plus 1. So it's going to be my identity line moved up 1. There it is. So look at your BFF card. Your identity goes through the origin, move it up 1. Now, what line am I looking at for this one, the pink one?
Right.
What's going to be line?
1.
I'm looking at the 1. Don't care about anything else, just the 1. That dot will be solid. Wait, I can't have all these.
Wait, solid. I think the 3x that's supposed to be open.
That's wrong. Thank you. I copied it wrong. Thank you, Scott.
Well,
so in the original problem on the sheet, that is not equal to. I wrote it wrong. Which means I have to open up that dot now. This one is closed. What part of that pink line am I keeping?
The right.
The right. So I'm going to erase this. So far I got this orange thing down here and this pink thing up here. What's in the middle?
Parabola.
A parabola. Let's see. Blue. There's my parabola. Which squiggly line impacts the parabola?
Both.
So I'm going to have an open dot here. Well, I'm going to have a big dot here and another big dot over here. And then, are either of these dots closed in?
The
-2. This one is. And then what do I keep and what do I erase? This one's a little trickier. This tells me what to keep. Isn't X in between the two?
Yeah, erase the outside.
So I'm going to keep that in between piece. So this one, very strange looking thing. I got a ray shooting up that way. Got a ray shooting down this way. And then I got this little bowl thing in between. All right, got 4 more to go. These are not piecewise. These are just your practice review of your BFFs. All right, so tell me about H. Oops. Tell me about H.
Exponential.
It's exponential. And how has it been moved?
Down 1.
Down 1. So I like to draw my regular picture here. This is my regular picture. That's what's on my note card. If I drop that down one, where will that point be?
Zero, zero.
Zero, zero. And where will this asymptote be? Originally, it's at zero.
Negative one.
If I drop it down one, won't it be now at negative one? And I have exactly the same shape I always have with an exponential. Tell me about it. What shape is it?
Logarithm.
And we know our normal logarithm. Looks like this. This is what your note card should look like. If it doesn't, make it look like that. That's what your logarithmic curve is. What have we done to this one?
There's the left one.
Left two. Now, guys and girls, that means everything is going left two. So this asymptote was at zero. Won't it now be back here at negative two? The asymptote. Was it zero? So back it up two. Now, what about this dot? It wasn't one. It's going to back up two, so it'll be at negative one. And everything else stays the same. What BFF is this? Cubing. And you know that the normal cubing, your note card, should have a squiggle through the origin like that.
Mm-hmm.
What are we doing to this guy?
Moving it right to.
So that means that it's not going to squiggle at the origin anymore. It's going to squiggle at 2. Right? I want right 2.
Yep.
So I'm going to draw my same shape, but now I'm squiggling through that one. All right, one more, and it's a double duty. What shape is problem K?
Square root.
Yep, so that's at the origin and arcs out like that. That's your square root. What have we done to this?
Right 3, up 4.
We went
to the right three, up four.
So this is the point 3, 4. Would everybody agree with that? And then it arcs out from there. Remember, the shape will never change. Just your starting point will change. You've moved it. Okay. All right. Let's go back now to 1.4 notes. They start on the back of page 10. By the way, we de-split this chapter, so we'll be having a test over 1-1 to 1-4. Alright? So we'll finish 4 probably in our next class, and then we'll review practice test 1, practice test 2, practice test 3, and we'll be ready for test. Alright? But we got to do 1.4. Here we go. So, we're on the back of page 10. Everybody's in the right spot. Right, Pete? We're in the right spot?
Yes.
And we are ready to look at function F and function G. And problem A says, add them together. We are not going to be confused by the notation. We're going to add these together. Okay? So what do you think that means? It's a snap. It's super simple. What do you think we're going to do? X plus 2. That's the F. And we're going to add it to X squared. That's the G. Can I collect any like terms there? Are there any like terms? No, but I probably should put it in order. But that's it. That's all there is to it. Do not solve it. In other words, no quadratic formula or anything. This isn't an equation. We're simply adding our two functions together. What do you think that means?
Two times
the f function. Well, the f function is x plus 2. So 2 times it is 2x plus 4. We are not confused by the notation. This is f. This is g. Do whatever it tells you to do. Add them together. Multiply them by 2. Subtract. Oops, I don't know what h is. H is negative 2x plus 5. So what am I going to do here? It says take G and subtract H. All right, what's G? It tells you.
X squared.
Then subtract H.
Plus 2 minus 5.
You want to be careful here. Because isn't h, function h, a quantity? So when I subtract it, I'm going to have to make sure that I distribute the negative. Because I have to subtract both pieces of it. Take a break. Okay? All right, D. Who hasn't talked today? What do you think about problem D? Yes, Jacob?
It would be parentheses x plus 2 close parentheses.
We're going to multiply these together, which basically is going to be a distribute problem. So x times x squared, what is that? That's x cubed. Very good. How can you guys mess that up sometimes? X cubed times, or plus, 2x squared? This could not be easier. We just do whatever it says. All right. Kaden? What do you think is happening in this one?
Is it x plus 2 divided by x squared?
Exactly. That's exactly right. Now, you're done. Don't think you can cancel in this problem. This is another one of those triangle things we've talked about before. If you're going to cancel something, it has to come out of every part. If it can't come out of every part, then don't do it. So that's it. You're done. That's the answer. All right, now I got to look at my answers. This was A, this was B, this was C, this was D, and this was E. All right, because it says, what is the domain? All right, look at this right here. Review. What's the domain of this guy? This right here. What's the domain of that? Ah, yes, The domain is all real numbers. Why? It doesn't break any of the rules. I love it. What are the rules?
If it's under a denominator.
So you gotta have a denominator, right? Or you gotta have a radical. We don't have it. So if it doesn't break any of the rules, then the domain is all reals. Perfect. What about B? This is the answer we got to B.
All reals.
Yeah. All right, here's the answer we got to C. Yeah, we're getting boring here. All reals. Here's the answer we got to D. Here's the answer we got to E.
Zero.
Not all reals. X cannot be
zero.
Remember, X squared cannot be, the denominator cannot be zero. So X can't be the square root of zero, which is
zero.
All right, hang on, we got just a little bit more to go. I'm going to use those same functions. Now the problem looks way different. Think back to last year. To break your other foot, dude? Break something over here? No, keep your head up. All right, anybody remember how to do this?
Plug two into G.
So we always start with what it's next to. Okay, so we're kind of going this way, which is odd. That's weird. We don't normally do it. So we're going this way. So we're going to start by finding g of 2. Now, that means come over to your g function and put in a 2. So g of 2 will be 2 squared. You see what I'm doing? When I evaluate a function, I put my number right in for the x. So that'll be 2 squared or 4. So this right here that I circled under my hand here, that's 4. Now what do I do with that 4? Now I have to put that 4 into f, because now it says f of 4. So I'm going to come back up here, and I'm going to do that, and f of 4 is 4 plus 2 or
6.
These are called composite functions. You know, the school down in the administrative hallway, they have composite pictures hanging up. It's a big thing with all the little pictures in it. This is a big function made up of little functions. You do them one at a time. So 2 into G, figure out what that is, and then take that answer and plug it into F. Now, composition, the composite function notation, can actually be written different ways. Problem H is exactly the same as problem G. The only difference is the way it is written. You can either write the functions like this, separated by brackets and parentheses, or you can put this little open circle in there. Mr. Miller always called that fog, but it's not really fog. It's a little open circle. It's not a zero. It's a little open circle. This works the same way as this. So you're going to plug 2 into G, and then that answer into F. So the answer would be the same. These are the same problem. Two notations for the same problem. All right, we're going to do one more. We're going to keep the same functions, the same number, but we're gonna do it in the other order. Look at problem I. Would you agree that we're doing this in backwards from that one?
Yeah.
Because here, we put two into G. Now we're gonna put two into F. Mm-hmm. All right, so what's F of two? F of 2 is 2 plus 2?
Yep.
Or 4?
Yep.
Now, that's this part. So now what do I do?
2 squared.
Plug 4 into G.
4 squared.
Which is 4 squared or 16. Does the order I do the problem matter?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Matters a lot. Mm-hmm. So you start with the letter attached to the number. So this one was F of 2, so I started with F. This one was G of 2, so I started with G. All right? Perfect. You covered a lot of ground and you did a great job. Next class, I'm going to give back a whole bunch of papers.